Good morning and welcome you all. It's a very exciting moment for us at IIT Bombay, where we are launching our own massive open online courses through the Extension Online Educational Service. This was approved by a committee long back, under which we ran our courses on EDX, and with that experience behind us, we will be launching these courses now. For this brief ceremony, I would like to invite the director, Professor Devang Kakkar, to chair the session.
Thank you.
Thank you, Devang. We also have amongst us the lead faculty members of the three courses which will be offered now. I am glad to invite Professor Vikram Gadre and Professor Uday Gaitonde. Please. Thank you. Professor Vikram Gadre, as head of CDEEP, is also the institute appointee for operational execution of all our online programs through CDEEP. So in that dual capacity also, I welcome you, Vikram. Thank you so much. I would just like to mention that this launch also sees the launch of three important online workshops for teachers. As you are all aware, we have been conducting T10KT programs for teachers, but these are part online and part face to face through remote centers. This is the first time, as per the recommendation and approval of the project review group, we are launching these workshops for teachers online. And the topics of these workshops is effective teaching and mentoring of students who register for online courses. So corresponding to these three online courses which we are launching today, we are also launching three teacher training workshops exactly on the same subject. These teachers will be trained on how to handle discussion fora, how to add explanations to difficulties that people raise, how to add additional examples, and as suggested by Professor Gadre, how to translate a given video lecture clip into an Indian language so that at the end of the course, we would probably have these courses available in multiple Indian languages. For the time being, we will be offering them in English and Hindi. For the three courses that are being offered, we have already prepared the Hindi transcripts, our teams have prepared. We will also be launching courses on this platform from some of the partner institutions and faculty colleagues as per the guidance from the Standing Committee and Project Approval Board of the National Mission. ICRISAT is one such organization which offers courses in agricultural sciences. They were asked to do a pilot course and run it on the IIT Bombay platform to begin with before their larger project is approved. They are ready with the course and their course may be announced in 2 or 3 days' time. Tata Institute of Social Sciences is developing a vocational training course on use of Blender for educational animation. The faculty leading that charge is Samir Sahasrabuddhe, who has ditched us and joined this. But that course is getting prepared. We have a stipulation that unless a minimum 3 weeks of course material is ready and is reviewed by our team, we will not announce the course, because it could be very dangerous that once you announce the course is not ready. So their course will be launched sometime during the month of February. Professor Mangal Sundar, esteemed colleague from IIT Madras, who ran NPTEL, as many of you would know, has offered to run his chemistry course, introductory chemistry course, on IIT Bombay X platform, and has agreed for the date of launch as March, which is exactly the date on which Professor Vikram Gadre's course also will be launched. So with this brief, I would request the director, Professor Kakkar, to say a few words and launch the site.
So good morning and Happy Republic Day to everybody. Just back from the other celebration to this celebration. So it's really a very auspicious day on which we are launching a very important initiative, that is this massively online open courses. You know, there has been a big evolution of trying to use technology for education. And you know, I was told that when the telegraph was invented, then everyone said that, you know, now you can easily transmit lectures over telegraph, so there's no need for universities. Then when the radio came, so then they thought definitely now the universities can, you know, close down, because now all lectures can be delivered over the radio. Then when television came, I mean, you know, there was much greater hope that there would be no need for teachers and universities and so forth. And then of course there was computer-based training, CBT, which went on for quite some time. But I think MOOCs is something very different, because for the first time, you know, there is a possibility of two-way interaction, because without some interaction with a teacher, it's very difficult to learn. And MOOCs offers this power that, you know, you may not have somebody in front of you, but there are fora in which you can pose your questions, you know, you can interact with your peers. And in some sense, you know, there is a person who can, you know, act as your teacher, even though not full time. So I think that now finally we have a mechanism which seems very promising to be able to, you know, bring education to millions of people at a relatively low cost. And that is something that's really needed for a place like India, where we have a huge number of students, more than 23 million. I don't know, maybe I'm getting that number wrong, 23 lakhs or 23 million, I'm getting it wrong. But a very large number of students. There are a huge number of colleges, and there are many teachers. But I think this vehicle of MOOCs can supplement what is going on. And I'm very glad that IIT Bombay is starting off this, and, you know, at least some of the best teachers of the institute are going to lecture in this program. I mean, all of them have won the Excellence in Teaching Award multiple times. So, you know, there's good evidence that we have picked the right people to deliver these courses, and their courses will go out to thousands of students at a relatively low cost to the student themselves. So with those few words, it's really something that we have been looking forward to for some time. And I would like to take this occasion to launch the course. I don't know what is the way to do it.
You will have to click on, you can just left click on the Mozilla tag, it will open, left click.
Left click.
Yes.
That's it?
That's it. Instantly, the site goes live now.
Now?
Yeah.
Okay, great. So, any of you who are interested, most welcome to log on to one of the courses. I will certainly go and look at it. So, congratulations to all those who have put in the tremendous work. For me, that left click didn't take much effort, but I know that huge amount of effort has gone in to come to this stage. So, congratulations and all the best.
There's a small animation which our animation team led by Kaumudi has prepared.
भारत में सर्वोत्तम शिक्षा प्रदान करने वाली संस्थाएं हैं, परंतु यह संस्थाएं सीमित विद्यार्थियों को शिक्षित करने के लिए ही सक्षम है। विशाल संख्या में विद्यार्थीगण उच्चतर शिक्षा प्राप्त करने के लिए उत्सुक है, ऐसे हर एक विद्यार्थी में बसता है एक एकलव्य। इस गणतंत्र दिवस के अवसर पर हमारे देश की सर्वोत्तम संस्थाओं में से एक भारतीय प्रौद्योगिकी संस्थान मुंबई की ऑनलाइन शैक्षणिक सेवाएं प्रस्तुत करती हैं आईआईटी बॉम्बे एक्स, उन सभी एकलव्यों के लिए एक ऑनलाइन मंच।
आईआईटी बॉम्बे एक्स, जहां आपको विविध पाठ्यक्रम सर्वोत्तम शिक्षकों द्वारा ऑनलाइन प्राप्त करने की सुविधा है। आईआईटी बॉम्बे एक्स पर आप सीख सकते हैं अपनी मातृभाषा में। सीखें जहां भी आप चाहें, सीखें जब भी आप चाहें, चाहे आप कहीं भी रहते हो, कुछ भी काम करते हो, बाहर हो या घर पर। आयु की मर्यादा यहाँ नहीं। व्यावसायिक शिक्षा प्राप्त करें, चाहे किसी भी व्यवसाय से जुड़े हो। IIT बॉम्बे एक्स की वेबसाइट पर जाएं, 3 आसान कदम अपनाएं, खोजें उपलब्ध पाठ्यक्रम, चुनें पसंदीदा पाठ्यक्रम और सीखें। IITBombayX.in।
So this is what they made. It is also available in English. The team prepared it very recently. So, without further ado, let me conclude this brief ceremony by offering a vote of thanks. There's actually a huge list of people to thank. To begin with, I'd like to thank the director for sparing his time. He agreed to come here after completing that ceremony, and God knows if we have to go for another ceremony now, I do not know. But thank you very much, sir, for coming here. I'm also grateful to all my faculty colleagues who have found their time from their own busy schedule. I would like to particularly thank the 3 teams of faculty colleagues who had earlier helped IIT Bombay X to run these courses globally, and now they are running these courses for Indian students and for Indian teachers. Professor Vikram Gadre, who leads the Signals and Systems course. Very unfortunately, his colleague from IIT Kharagpur, who gave the original course, is no more, late Professor Sen Gupta, who was the PI for the T10KT program there. Professor Uday Gaitonde has been a veteran of teachers training workshops, and this time he is joined with his colleagues Professor Bhandarkar and Professor Milind Datre in both teaching the online course to students and also for the training workshop in thermodynamics, and that course launches from now. I am also grateful to my colleague Professor Supratik Chakrabarty, who has joined me in running the global course and now joins me in running the teachers training program as well as this online course. There are a large number of teaching assistants and course teams, particularly for CS101 we had Nagesh Karmari and Firuza Aibara, who actually helped to run even CS101 in blended MOOCs this last semester with Supratik and us. And I have no doubt that there will be other colleagues like that in the other courses. The most important people I would like to thank on this occasion is a very large team from the National Mission Projects, which have been working tirelessly for several months initially to work on the SWAYAM platform, which the ministry had directed. Since SWAYAM is getting delayed, they had to hurriedly convert a whole lot of things, both in software and content, for the IIT Bombay X platform. I would like to begin with Professor Kannan Maudgalya, who is the co-PI for this project and also the coordinator of all national mission projects. Unfortunately, as usual, he is either in Coimbatore or in Bhuj or someplace. He's not in IIT Bombay. He's trying to spread the word. But his contributions have been absolutely extraordinary in all the mission projects. There are 3 advisors who at the very senior level advises on various components of the activities. One is Mr. Avinash Aute, who has not been able to come. Single-handedly he has led the team for the complete software development. In fact, under his leadership, Aparna is here. Yes, Aparna and her team actually prepared the blended MOOCs platform which we used last year in CS101 and now the IIT Bombay X. Professor Prakash Vaidya, who is actually an expert in embedded systems, but he specializes in correct documentation and proof editing, so he has been a source of inspiration to all our team. And last but not the least, Professor Pradeep Verma, who was a senior consultant in MHRD. He left that MHRD job to pursue his academic inclinations by becoming an adjunct professor in IIT Kanpur, where he's teaching management courses. We requested him to join us as our advisor part-time, which he does now. And he has been instrumental earlier for the SWAYAM launch and also for our variety of activities. we have several senior managers who lead individual teams. I would like to recognize them. Dr. Mukta Atre, who is currently in NIT Agartala with one of my faculty colleagues, Professor Milind Atre. They are visiting NIT Agartala now. She leads our T10KT workshop team. Kalpana Kannan, who leads our content team. Parag Tiwari, yeah, he's there. He is actually the project management office and also a technical lead on variety of issues related to this particular software and software management. Sajjan Dixit, he is the head of our audio-video team. Jayashila Gaitonde, who handles our accounts and makes money available from the projects. We have so far not had a single occasion where we had to go to Dean R&D to beg for funds. So that way we're lucky. Rajesh Kushalkar, who ably led the Akash project and now participates in the Clicker application development and incorporation of T10KT workshops. Shaukat Ali, who leads the logistics team. Although he handles the Akash logistics, he is also in charge of all procurement related activities for the national mission projects. And Satyajit Gopi, who currently heads our benchmarking team, he has confirmed that our new site, which is the last man I would like to acknowledge, is Abhilash, who is the head of our system administrators team and creator of the micro cloud. Very quietly, by using an approval from the ministry, we have created a micro cloud here. And Gopi confirmed that it can handle up to 1 lakh registrations in 1 hour. And also the online quizzes and everything. So we have run benchmarks to ensure that once we launch, we don't fall flat. I would particularly like to thank the software team leaders and their teams. So Aparna, do you have anybody else from your team here today? No, they're all working. She has come only for a short time. She is going to go back to check minor things. But thank you, Aparna, to you and your team. Shweta, the NME ICT software team leader. Oh, she is also working. She and Deepesh are working on the mass mailing. Right. So you'll be glad to know that apart from the press conference, which has already carried the good word elsewhere, we are in touch with about 1 lakh teachers through our T10KT program. All 1 lakh teachers over the next 8 to 10 hours will receive a personal email giving details of these courses along with an attachment which is a notice for their students which they are expected to put up on their notice boards. I believe that this mechanism to outreach is much better than just the press or something like. So the teams are unfortunately busy doing that thing. Abhilash, I already acknowledged and introduced. He has a team of several sysadmins. System administrators, sir, are called gods in our parlance because they only permit or unpermit you to touch a machine. So they are important people for us. Content team, Kalpana is aided by Kiran Khosla for the Hindi translation work. Kaumudi for the educational animation. Kaumudi is here. She is the one who has made that Eklavya thing. And there is a young chap called Nitin Iyer. He is a very unique person. He spent so much time on the project that has not yet completed his own degree. So he is appointed on an honorarium basis for several things. But he performs a task that about 10 graduates would ever do together. So we are thankful, Nitin, to you and to your team. Bhairav is the artist who actually made that all the backdrops and everything. Thank you one and all, and let us hope that this initiative goes out to lakhs of students in the coming weeks and months. Thank you so much. Thank you. I'm glad to offer a small memento for this. It's only an IIT Bombay Cup, nothing more. Vikram.